Okay, so today we have exercise 7D, another type of measuring perspective. So I call it measuring perspective method C. It's called parallel perspective, that's what we will describe today. But I am not concerned with naming, like what is this method called. Important for you to know how to use it, okay? So measuring perspective method C. Until now, the method A and method B, when I explained, we used two-point perspective. But we haven't used one-point perspective yet. So this method will use one-point perspective. And this method is mostly used when you draw, for example, rooms, open spaces, and you want to show what's inside. Most of the time, it is used for this purpose, okay? And using the one-point perspective. So, we will draw a very simple room, okay? Opened. As you know, one-point perspective, you have to start with a face, okay? And then go towards one point. So, we will draw a simple room with a few things inside to show you how to use it. It is an accurate method, again, using measurements. Now, you can always draw sketches from these, you know, but once you want to do a final drawing, it has to be used with the correct measurements. So, we use scale 1 to 50 this time, and the room size is 4 meter length, 4 meter width, 4 meter and height 3 meters. Now, 4 meter, how much centimeter? 400. Okay, 400 centimeter, 400 divided by 50, according to the scale, it equals 8 centimeter on the paper. Okay, because we are drawing on a very small A3 size paper, we need to reduce it. So we need a high scale here. So 8 centimeter on the paper. The same with the width, 8 centimeter. So length and width, 8 centimeter, 8 by 8. The height, 3 meters, which equals to 300 centimeter. 300 divided by 50 equals 6 centimeter on the paper, okay? Now, each centimeter on the paper equals to 50 centimeter in reality, half meter, okay? Each 2 centimeter equals 1 meter in the real room. So, here I started drawing, 8 centimeter by 8. I started drawing the top view of this room. Now notice something here. We already, in method B, when I explained, we already had something similar. So we had a picture plane line with a top view. But we started above. So we had the picture plane line here. We draw the top view here, and then we have station point, and you take the points down and find the location. This method very similar. It's very similar, but you start from below, not from above, from below, okay? So from underneath, you draw the picture plane line, you draw the top view, the plan view, here, okay, below. So it's very similar. All of the methods have something in common. Once you know one method, easy to understand the other method. So, I draw the top view, the plan view of the room here, okay? And I draw it in this way because it's going to be in one-point perspective, so we don't have here a point, a corner like before when we did the method B. We had a corner because we have two-point perspective. And we have to start with an edge. With one-point perspective, we start with a face. Okay, so we draw it in this way, with the correct measurement. So 8 centimeter by 8 centimeter. The height we will know when we draw it here. Okay. So after you do this, you need to also draw all the furniture pieces, what you want to put inside the room, here as a top view. So if you have something here, for example, going on, in this, where is the space for the doors, the windows, any other details inside the room, tables, chairs, everything you have to draw from the top view here. Because the location is very important. So if you put a chair here, it's going to look different than if you put it here or here, okay? So everything what you want to put inside this room must be drawn. So if we want to draw this classroom, we will have a lot of rectangular shapes here because of the tables. How do they look from the top? Like a rectangle, okay? So, so we will have all here rectangles, but we will not draw the classroom. Okay, the next step to do is what? After you draw the picture plane line and after you draw the correct measurements of this room, what is the next step? You need to find the station point. Like before, we have a station point. Now this station point, in this case, I make it here 90 degrees, but it doesn't have to be. You know, this distance from here to here, this is where the viewer looks at the room. So if you make it, for example, a different degree, let's say you put it here, what will happen? It means that the viewer is more far away from the room. So what you will end up here is a smaller drawing. A smaller drawing because the viewer is more far away. If the viewer comes closer here, this distance become closer, the room will become here more bigger, okay? It will appear more bigger in perspective because the viewer comes close. So what is this angle? It's not, it doesn't have to be 90 degrees, okay? Also, it does not have to be, no need to be in the middle, no need. I can put it here, for example. That means I'm looking at the room from this angle. But what you will see here will be different than if you stand in the middle or stand a little bit this way or this way, okay? Just so that you know in future when you draw something that this does not have to be in the middle, okay? Why I put it here in the middle? Because I want you to draw it like this so that the object that you will end up here, everybody will have the same size. Not one person to draw here small, one person big. So I want to check that you know the technique correct, and I want to see the mistakes easily. So that's why I want everybody to use here a 90 degree, okay? And to draw exactly in this way. But in the future, it can be more far away. It doesn't have to be in the middle. And you can test it at home. You can test a quick drawing, how it will look like if I put it somewhere else. So, we have an SP point. Now, to find the location of where this is going to be, this object, the same like in method B. We take from SP through the point, this point, okay, we will take it up, and we know the size of the room. If it was far away, what will happen? Okay, if we take it, it will become smaller. Again, if I put it more closer and I take these points, look, it will be much bigger. This is in the perspective depending on the viewer location. Okay, in this case, we have it here. So through this point we need, through this point we need. We also need these two points here. So these two points, I will take them up also. If you remember in method B, we had what? One point. One point. If you remember here, the corner, we had one point and we take it down. Here we have two points. We take them up because they are already on the line. Now, I will draw, let's see. There is no rule what space to leave here. But if you leave too little space, sometimes later you will not have space to draw the entire room, okay? So there is no rule here. Let me try to start with this object here. Now, the height, we said what? 6 centimeters, okay? So this should be 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this should be 8. The height, 6. So So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So until here. Okay. Okay. Now, so what did we do? These 2 points we take up and we draw our room with the height, the required height, according to scale. Now, as I said, from here to here, how much distance you leave, there is no rule. I cannot tell you leave this much space because it depends on the station point where these 2 points are, how big the second rectangle will be. I cannot know that. Okay, so if you see that your space not enough, you know, you can move this object up. And I advise you when you draw the homework to draw vertical the paper. Okay, so this is the A3 Fabriano. Draw like this to have enough space. Okay, let's continue now here. Now, we have to find 2 more lines. We need to find the ground line and the horizon line and the vanishing point. The ground line is this line. So, this is the ground we are standing. It's on this line, okay? So, let me draw the ground line. So this is the ground line. The horizon line will be the line on which the vanishing point will be located. One vanishing point. Now this also change. Like this changes. Like if you put it here, it will be different. If you put it here, if you put it in the middle. It depends on where are you looking at this room. So if you're a very short person and looking, my horizon line will be here. If I'm here, my horizon line will be here. So, it depends on where you want to put it. And that's up to you or up to the teacher who will tell you. Sometimes they use the average height of the person, like for example, 1 meter 70 centimeter, and they use this as a normal standard, for example, line of a horizon line, okay? But it's not a rule, so it depends. Now, in our case, in your homework, you need to do it in the middle, okay? Everything in the middle to keep it simple until you learn the technique. Later you can change and experiment, okay? So we will keep it in the middle. So that means 1, 2, 3, where is number 3? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So from number 3, so this will be the horizon line. Now, exactly in the middle, I will put the vanishing point. Again, this does not have to be the case. Maybe I want from here to put the vanishing point, or here, or here, or here. But what you will see in the room will be different. So if I stand here, for example, and I look at the room, it's different than if I stand exactly in the middle and I look at the room. I will see the furniture, everything different, okay? Great. But to make things easy, and everybody's drawings the same, we will use everything in the middle. So from number 4 here, I will put a line up. And here will be the vanishing point. Our vanishing point. Okay, now what? From this vanishing point, pay attention, from this vanishing point, we take a straight line through this corner, okay? Then continue until it intersects this line, this SP. Look, SP point, this point, we found its location. Now this line up straight, from here, vanishing point through this corner, where it will intersect these 2 lines, here is the perspective, basically end of our room. So here I must end it. Here it will end. Now, also up, how much? Again, from the vanishing point through this corner, where it will intersect. So here. The other two are very easy. The same thing. So from here through this corner, it must end in this. So if they don't intersect perfectly, there is some mistake in your drawing. From here through here. The object on which we have all the measurements. Everything will start from these and this side with the measurements and the vanishing point. So all the objects that we will draw, we will consider these. Okay? So I will draw example to show you. Now, before I draw any object inside here, let me draw these tiles. You see, I divide it into every centimeter, I divide it into tiles. This is not something you have to do, but it helps, you know, it helps to find the location of the objects. And if you don't want to do it, for example, I don't want to have tiles in my room, you can use very easily, for example, if you have an object, for example, a door starting from here, ending here, how to find the location of the door? Very easy, from SP through this point, where it will intersect this line, then take it up, okay, it will intersect here. Then from SP through this point, where it will intersect, take it up, it will end here. So the same like in method B. SP has to touch each of these points, then you will see where it will intersect this line. You take straight lines up and find the location on these lines. But the tiles help you with quick identification of the spaces. So it's useful to have it. So what I will do, so this is 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3, 4, I divided the tiles. From each of these points, or these points, they are the same, SP through this point, it's located here. SP through this point, located here. From SP through this point, here. Then this point, then this point, then this point, then this point. I found the location on this line. Now we will take them up. See where they will intersect this line. Okay. So, I will put the lines up now. Here. And where each of these points intersected this line, I don't need to do it here because I already have this side and I can complete it. Now, to complete our tiles, because they're square, okay, from the vanishing point through each one of these, this is 8 centimeter, okay? You will take straight lines from each and see where they will cross. From the vanishing point, thank you. So. What did we do here? From the vanishing point through each centimeter, okay, we put lines and they intersected these lines, the horizontal lines. And so we know now we have our objects which will help us here, the tiles on the floor, to help us locate other objects. Okay. Now, to continue, let me just delete a little bit this so it's not overloaded here with lines. Too much lines here. Okay. Okay. Now what? We have here two windows. The measurements, where are they located? They start from the start of the window. Look, there is a line here and a line here. The start is at 1.5 centimeter, then go 2 centimeter, then 1 centimeter space, another window 2 centimeter, then 1.5 centimeter. So, I need to locate it here. So, location is very easy because I can take the lines up from here. Take straight lines up. Are they straight? Not so straight. Okay. Straight lines up. And here also straight line up. From here the same. And here the same. So my window is going to be located here, but what is, okay, what is their starting point from here now and the finish point here? So what did I write here in my papers? Said 1 centimeter, so in reality 1 meter, okay? So from here, from this, this line intersects these lines, this point, and this point, okay? Now, from the floor, how much up? I put 2 centimeter. So from here, 1, 2. It will intersect this line and this line here and this line here and this line here. So our windows are located in this space exactly. Now you have to do another thing, okay? From the top view, this is not visible from the, you know, plan view, not visible, but we have here another detail. So from the middle of the window, which is, this is 1, 1, 2, 3. So 1.5 from here, another line through the middle. So this is the middle, this is the middle. From here, I want you to put a half circle also. So this is here. It's not going to be exactly half circle because this is 1.5 centimeter by 1.5 by 1.5. So this is a perfect square. So inside, I want you to draw like this. So this is here the diagonals. This is here the midpoint. So from here to here. And Here the same, from here, touching here, going down here. So this is not a half circle because it takes the whole, but once you have the points, the midpoint, here this point, you just connect and draw an even looking curve, okay? And from here to here, 1.5, from here to here, 1.5. Okay. Now, what do we have here drawn? I have a door which start here and finish here, and it's two centimeter or two tiles. Now, because I made all these tiles, it's very easy to find. I don't need to take from SP through this point, find here, from SP through this point, find here, and take it up. Because here I can already count. So, one, two, so, one, two. My door starts here. And ends where? Another two. So, one, two. Now, how high? You need to know the height, okay? Let me see what I put. Okay, it has to end, the door has to end 1 meter down from the ceiling. So, 1 meter from where we measure? Not from here, from here. 1 meter equals 1 centimeter, so 1 centimeter. Now, from this point, here's 1 centimeter from here, okay? The vanishing point, from the vanishing point through this, a line. Now, these two lines, where they will intersect, here is the location. Will intersect here, the other one. Intersect here. So this is the height of the door, okay? Everything you measure from here and take the vanishing point through it and see where it will intersect the other lines. Okay. Now other details, the handle of the door, everything, you know, you can put that later to more and more. If I want to draw the door open, for example, there will be a... the wall thickness from here, how much the wall thickness will be. I didn't draw it here, so I will. It's not advisable to draw it. If I want the wall thickness, it will be here drawn, okay? Then I can take from SP through the point and find its location, or from here I can find it. For example, let's say it's 0.25 centimeter, for example. So from here, 0.25, okay, half of this, I will take, and from this side, half of this, then vanishing point through here. Then from here, straight line, continue, from here, straight line. Then from this point where they intersect, you will take it up. And again, from this point to the vanishing point, okay? So this is the... if you have an open door and a thickness of the wall, okay? And everything you start measuring from here. So we had to add another here, 0.25. But if you add something here, you must have it here. Don't forget, okay? So here we must also have the wall thickness. We cannot have something here and not have it here, or the opposite. So this thing must be planned beforehand. This is not required of you, the wall thickness, okay? So consider not exist. This is for example, okay? For as an example. If you have, for example, a window in this side and the window is transparent, so you will see some of the wall thickness, okay? Just to make the drawing more realistic. In the future, maybe you have to add these things, not only the location. Okay. Now I put something very simple here, a furniture piece that starts here and ends here. So it starts at this point, Okay? And we'll finish after 1, 2, 3. So it will start here and finish. 1, 2, 3. It will finish here. But how high? How high? Later we will find out. Okay? Now, what is this size? From here to here. Here it's 1. Okay? So, 1. Okay? We put from this corner up. Here we already have up. From then 1, 2, 3. From this also we need up. Now, the height from where? From here. Okay? So, what is the height of this? 1. Okay, 1 centimeter again. So, from here, 1. Then this one, the vanishing point must go with a straight line through 1. Continue until here. Now, all of these lines, look, this line intersect here. So we already know the height, okay? Now, from this point to the vanishing point again. This here intersect here, so we stop. So from here to the vanishing point. And this line must go up and touch this line. So this is, and here our object will end. Now more details that we cannot see from the top view, you will add here, okay? Like for example, divisions, it has some divisions, this furniture piece. All of this will be at the back, so you will not see it. This will be, okay? So these pieces, for example, here, you can add more details. If you have thicknesses, for example, thicknesses of some sort, again, you will start from here measuring. From here, how much down the thickness, through the vanishing point, find it. Nothing freehand in a measuring perspective, nothing. But everything you measure from here, or from here, or from here, of course, and then the vanishing point has to go through the measurement and see where here the lines will intersect. Always remember this. Then more and more details you can add, you know, to the furniture piece and so on, okay, to complete it. Okay. What else did I put here? I put here some object here in the middle, divided in two. So this 1 centimeter and 1 centimeter and this 2 centimeter. And this is going to be located not on the floor, on the ceiling here. Like some kind of a light or, you know, like coming down from the ceiling. It doesn't matter what it is. I'm just drawing to show you how to draw, okay? So the shape, not important right now. But what I mean is when you have this plan view, the objects on the floor and the objects on the ceiling, everything must be drawn here, the location. Because what if this object located here? It will be different place, okay? So you need to place it in the correct location, every single detail. Even if you have a table, for example, if you draw this table from the top, how it looks like a rectangle, okay? But you need to identify, okay, where are the legs? So you need to draw also the legs, everything, okay? Every detail, because all of these have points. So, for example, from the station point, you can take through these points and find their location here. And measuring from the back, going through the vanishing point. So everything what you have in this place, you must draw it from the top and placed in their correct place. This is very important. And the correct size. Choose for them the correct size. Okay, so this object, how do we draw it? It's from the top, from here, somewhere. First, we find its location. So this is here, starting 1, and this 1 here. So 1, 1. So I put straight lines up. And from here, the same thing. Now, I need to find somewhere on these two lines, there will be this point, and this point, and this point, and this point. How do we find that? Well, from here, 1, 2, 3 centimeter. So, it must start from here, 1, 2, 3. I already make the tiles, so they can help me. If you don't want to use the tiles, you can, from SP through this point, find where it will intersect this line, then take a straight line up and find the location. The same thing, okay? But here I have it more easy. 1, 2, 3, okay. 1, 2, 3, okay. From here, up a line. It will intersect this line here. And what else do we have? Which line did we just take? Okay. This line here, 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, another 2 centimeter, okay? So from here, 1, 2. It's the same like the door size, basically. Let me see if it's located here. Okay, no. Here's something I didn't see. The door starts from here to here, but this one starts 1 centimeter after. So 1 centimeter after, here is the point we want, up. So here it will intersect, then 1, 2, 1, 2, here. Okay, so these 2 points I need. These 2 points, straight lines, we will take them. Now, very important, okay? Now, I put these 2 lines up, but we don't need them up until here. We need from the vanishing point, this space here, from here to here, which is how much? 1, 2. So, from here, let me see how we take it up. This one here, somewhere here, and this one line somewhere here. So, this should be 1, from here to here, 1, from here to here, also 1. So from the vanishing point now, from the vanishing point, we'll take through these lines up. Very careful. Straight lines. From the vanishing point through here, a line up. Also in the middle, because we will need it. Now, be careful. The vanishing point, okay, so this size, how much? 2, okay? This is 2. But from here, we take the measurement. The vanishing point through 2, okay, it will go this way. Now, it will intersect this line and this line in these 4 points. Here, 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 and here. This is the location of this object. Now, we have another line here in the middle. So, where is the middle of this? From here to here, it's here. This. Okay, so this object up, and then go this way. So here we have in the middle also a line. And we have this, and we have this. And this, and this. So now we draw this object on the ceiling, but there is no thickness to it. There is no height. Okay, so what is the height? What is the height? From where do we measure the height? We can put the lines down. For example, I can put them down, down, down. But where to stop? You need a real measurement. So in my case, what did I put? 0.5. 0.5 centimeter. From where do I take this 0.5? Okay? From this line here. Okay? So this is 1. 0.5, for example, here in the middle. Then, this line. Now this line here, where it will intersect these 2 points, it's very hard to see here now because it's very overlap, but where they will intersect from the vanishing point through this here, and you will get another 2 lines like this that go to the vanishing point, and another line that goes like this to the vanishing point, And we put this down, we put this down. So where this will touch, where these two will touch, and this one, here is the end with the height. So we can draw now the line here, the line here, the line here. So now it has a height to it as well. So again, we start from here measuring the height. Then we take it through the vanishing point and see where it will intersect the lines. This is very important because as you can see here, it's not 0.5. So everything starts from this place through the vanishing point, and then you see where the other lines will intersect in this view because this is a perspective view now. This is just a visual here, the rest, okay? So this, how big this is, will depend on what, where the viewing point will be, the SP. So if you put it here, for example, so all this will be smaller, okay? If you put this closer to here, to this line, this will open more and this will be bigger. But that doesn't mean anything because this will stay still the same. This will be still 6 and this will be 8. And all the measurements you measure from here, then through the vanishing point, you take them and you see where they will intersect the other lines and find any object in your room. So this one disappeared here. Vanishing point here. So our top object, where it's located now, here, and here, and here, to be more clear, huh? Now this is the basic, but maybe I don't like this design, okay? I like to have thickness in this area, in this area, in this area, for example. So these details, later you will add, because they are not visible from here, everything. But if you want to be really detailed, the thicknesses you need to also put here. You need to put the thicknesses here, and then decide either with the SP point where they will intersect here, not freehand like this, okay? So anything that have measurement, you need to find either from here, from SP, from this line, take out, or find its location through the squares that you draw the tiles, if it's you know, clear, and then from the vanishing point, take the lines and find the intersection. So keep this in mind. So any details to your designs, whatever you have here, furniture in the room, this is also thicknesses, anything details must be measured, not freehand, not a sketch, okay? So here, when you draw with pencil, please, any, as I said, so if you have a table, for example, and you have some, for example, the location of the legs, you will not draw them in this way. You will draw them very light and with dotted lines, okay? So that we know that this is below this surface, okay? And any details, for example, I have a thickness here of something. Below something. So you will draw it again with dotted line. But here it's not visible if I draw it. On the paper, you just play with the line thickness. So I want to see all the lines, visible, hidden lines, everything. Because I need to see every detail, how you took it up, how you constructed it here. It must be very detailed to draw it. Now, what do you need to do for the homework? What do you need to do? Pay good attention. You need to start, okay, with these measurements. So 8 by 8 centimeter room. It must have a height 6 centimeter, exactly like how I did here. The SP point must be 90 degree, exactly in the middle, okay. And here, the ground line, where you put the ground line, just be careful to have enough space in this location. So after you draw this, to have enough space, not to overlap, I mean, okay? So leave enough space. If you draw it and you don't have enough space, delete it and move this object up. Then, the vanishing point and the horizon line, again, exactly in the middle at 3 centimeters. the vanishing point exactly in the middle, okay, of this surface. And then from then on, from the vanishing point, you take this out, these lines out, where they will intersect these lines that go from the station point through these two points, where they will intersect, here you stop, okay? And you draw the surface here. So, if you do these steps exactly how I did them, everybody will have the same size drawing, the same size. I need everybody to have the same size so that I can check any mistakes easily, okay? If everybody has different size, it will become a mess. But in the future, as I said, you can change the location of the station point. You can make it down, up, depending on the location of the viewer, even to the side. Everything works, okay? Now, so these measurements, this measurement, 90 degree, must be exactly like how I did it. And now, inside here, what to do? These two windows must be exactly how I did them, okay? So they must start at 2 centimeters, then 1, 2, 3, end, okay, here. Then 1 centimeter must be left space. And from here the same. So 1, 2, then 1.5, then 1, then 1.5, from here to here, and then 2. So let me put it down here exactly. So from here to here, 1.5, then from here to here, 2, then from here to here, 1, not to get confused, this from here to here, 1, then from here to here, 2, then from here to here, another 1.5. And this here is clear, okay, where they start, where they finish. Okay. The door also. All of you must do it, but without the thickness. Okay, without the thickness here. Just the location of this door. And it starts where? Here and ends here. It starts at 2 centimeters in, then another 2 centimeters. So 2 centimeters inside, 2 centimeters, and you will be left with another 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 centimeters until the back. So, we need to draw the tiles also, okay? The tiles also for practice and for to help you find the location of the other objects. The rest is up to you. Like this, you don't have to draw it. This is just as example I put it. This here, you don't have to draw it. It's for example, okay? You do your own objects. So, maybe you want to draw a chair here or a table or more objects inside or... What you want to draw here, up to you, okay? For you, you must decide. And you must use the correct measurements and show me how you draw it correct, with the heights, with everything, but you choose. So I want 2 windows, a door, and the rest, up to you, what you draw. What shapes, what objects, up to you. But I want to see them where? Here, from the plan view, everything must be clear. If I take a ruler through the points, they have to match. Everything has to be according to the rules. Any questions about this? Again, it will be clear more on the paper because the lines are more thin, more clean, and you can see the object that you draw more clear. But the construction needs to start exactly in the order that I placed. So this is measuring perspective using 1-point perspective to draw interiors.